kojic acid, how it works in the skin, what the benefits and risks of using it are, and what you should look for when you buy a kojic acid product. If you have tried kojic acid yourself, please share your recommendations in the comments below. If you're new here, welcome. I'm Dr. Anne, a physician passionate about skincare and well aging. Legend has it that when looking at the hands of Japanese women working in sake production, you would be amazed by how youthful and bright they look compared to the rest of the person. And that the reason for that was that they handled the fermenting ingredients day in and day out, as sake is made by parallel fermentation. I have talked about the benefits of fermented ingredients in skincare before, but didn't mention kojic acid, which is a fermentation byproduct produced by different fungi used in the process. As it is with most of these ingredients today, it is mostly lab-made now to meet the demand, but some brands still use traditional ferment filtrate as signature ingredient. Despite being called acid, it is not exfoliating, but instead works as an antioxidant, has antimicrobial and antifungal properties, and is skin brightening, so works on lightening hyperpigmentation. When you look at the different ways hyperpigmentation can be targeted, it falls in the category of tyrosinase inhibitors, meaning it hinders the enzyme tyrosinase in taking the necessary conversion steps to create melanin after being activated by a trigger like UV radiation. There are different ways tyrosinase can be inhibited, and kojic acid does that by being a copper chelator, so by grabbing and binding the copper, tyrosinase needs to work most efficiently. And when no new melanin is produced, the hyperpigmented cells slowly slough off and the new ones underneath are light and bright. Depending on what you did before to target pigmentation, you can see results as early as 2 weeks after starting the treatment, but you will need up to 3 months until you reach what can be considered the final results. Obviously, kojic acid is not the one magic bullet that completely evens out your skin tone. In a study done on 204 people with varying forms of hyperpigmentation, think melasma, sunspots or post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, 45% reported moderate improvement and 74% reported slight to moderate improvement. The best results were across all studies achieved when kojic acid was used in conjunction with other skin brightening ingredients. Basically, your hyperpigmentation will not disappear once you start using kojic acid in your routine, but it is reasonable to expect to see any dark spots getting lighter. This is not a permanent effect though, as the melanocytes are not destroyed, just the enzyme blocked. When you stop using it and are exposed to hyperpigmentation triggers, it will reappear. The good news is that kojic acid is safe to use long term though. It does not get absorbed into the bloodstream in relevant concentrations and it isn't very good at penetrating the skin into the deeper layers. So unlike you have to with hydroquinone, there is no need to take a break. You can keep using it for the rest of your life. What can happen though is that you develop contact dermatitis to it, meaning a red itchy rash, especially when you use high concentrations or paired with other potentially irritating ingredients. The higher the concentration, the more likely you are to see problems, which is why no more than 1% kojic acid is approved for use in cosmetics. If you get a prescription from your dermatologist, between 1 to 4% are possible. Due to the fact that there are no relevant bloodstream levels with topical application, kojic acid is deemed safe to be used in pregnancy. In general, kojic acid can be paired with anything if you keep the golden rule in mind that less is always more when it comes to combining different potentially irritating ingredients. You will often find it in combination with other ingredients to target hyperpigmentation like vitamin C, azelaic acid, or often used in prescription paired with hydroquinone. Pairing it with hydroquinone has the benefit that when you need to go on your hydroquinone break, you can continue the kojic acid for upkeep of results. Another very promising pairing is with glycolic acid, probably due to the fact that the glycolic helps the pigmented cells shed easier and by exfoliating allows kojic acid to penetrate to where it needs to be more easily. Products with kojic acid come in various different forms, with kojic acid soaps being the thing that push the ingredient into the spotlight. Although anecdotal reports show great results with these, I personally would opt for a leave-on product if your skin can tolerate it, so a serum or a cream. Kojic acid isn't the most stable and oxidizes when it comes in contact with air and sunlight, so the packaging plays an important role too. I will leave some suggestions in the description box. As kojic acid has antimicrobial and anti-inflammatory effects in addition to the skin brightening qualities, it is very well suited for those with acne, especially if they react with post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation to breakouts. It's also a good option for those trying to get or being pregnant and for those that, for whatever reason, can't or don't want to use hydroquinone or retinoids. It is often recommended for people with deeper skin tones, as the way it works means it is less likely to cause overall lightening of the skin. If there is anything you would like to add, please do so in the comments below. I will link to more videos you might find interesting on the screen and add links to my Instagram, blog and Patreon account in the description box. See you soon. Bye!